Today, we're gonna use some sugar, some cream, and with a little bit of science, we're gonna speed up the process to make, you guessed it, ice cream. And it's gonna happen so fast, it will look like magic. So, grab your favorite toppings and a cherry frog on top. We're cooking with impossible science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, and today I'm gonna show you how to cook with impossible science. Now, if you love ice cream as much as I think you do, especially for me, I love homemade ice cream. The biggest problem with it is it takes forever to freeze. So, with a secret ingredient, I'm gonna show you how to make homemade ice cream instantly. And it uses liquid nitrogen. Don't laugh, this is how I cook in my house.
Okay, let's do some impossible science cooking. Now, you're gonna need a few things. You're gonna need whatever flavor you wanna make in this ice cream. I haven't decided if I was gonna go chocolate chip or strawberry, so I kinda got ready for both. You're gonna need about a cup and a half or 2 cups of strawberries. You're gonna need 2 tablespoons of vanilla. You're gonna need 2 cups of sugar, a cup and a half of half and half, and 4 cups of heavy whipping cream. You're also gonna need some safety goggles. You're gonna need some cryo gloves and some liquid nitrogen. This experiment is as much fun as it is tasty. I highly recommend. Now, you can do this with any recipe for ice cream that you find online. Mainly the part that really makes it taste amazing is the liquid nitrogen, because it's actually freezing so quickly that you don't get those water molecules and air bubbles. And ice cream's more dense, it's creamier, it's smoother. It's amazing to taste. All right, now, the funny part about this is it's exactly what it looks like. You just mix it together and stir. Now, you're gonna want a metal bowl or a stainless steel bowl. Now, you can use a metal whisk, but I highly recommend a thick spoon, because it freezes so quickly that you can easily overfreeze it and it's a little hard to stir. Now, don't worry about overfreezing it, because it melts and you can just stir it again. So, let's get started. Okay, first thing we're gonna do, 2 tablespoons of vanilla. All right. Then we're gonna follow it up with the 2 cups of sugar. All right, then the cup and a half of half and half. And finally, the 4 cups of a heavy whipping cream. And that's it. I know, it's pretty amazing. In fact, if you wanted to wait, you could mix this up and just stick it in the freezer and wait hours. Now you wanna stir it so you can make sure you get rid of all that sugar at the bottom. Doesn't take very long. Now at this point, you've made vanilla ice cream, and if you were to just add liquid nitrogen or freeze it, it would be vanilla ice cream. We'll add in a cup and a half of strawberries. Kinda smashed them in there, so. You can also add a little bit of dye if you wanna try to get that pink color in there. But I think I'm just gonna leave it with white. And I'm gonna put some chocolate chips in there, because that's awesome. Chocolate strawberry. Now, let's set that aside. Let's go over the liquid nitrogen. Now this is a doer. This is used for transporting liquid nitrogen. Inside here, I have a couple of utensils that allows me to pour out little bits at a time. This is the lid. This is literally the cap. It doesn't even actually screw into this because it's rapidly turning to gas. So if I were to screw this lid tight, or if there was a lid on it, it could be very dangerous because it'd be rapidly expanding into gas. This liquid is so much colder than the surface it's touching that if you look closely, it's beating into little pieces. If it were to touch my hand, it's actually turning to a gas faster than it is sitting in one spot. And so these little droplets are actually rolling on a cushion of gas, nitrogen gas to be exact, and it rolls off my hands. Now, the reason we wear gloves is we just don't want this to seep into anything in our hands, because it's really about something being really cold in one spot that could actually be dangerous. But right now you can actually see, how cool is that? That is just wild. And if I were to spill it on the table, you can actually just see it beating off. Perfect for Halloween. Now, this is the nitrogen gas that's just coming out. Now, if I were to pick this up, you can actually see the parts of it is turning into ice cream already. How crazy is that? Now it's only freezing a little bit because I didn't put enough liquid nitrogen in it. So I'm about to put in more, but I just wanted to be able to stop so you can see what it's starting to look like. The more liquid nitrogen I put in there, the more it's gonna freeze. So let's add some more liquid nitrogen. Put on my gloves, make sure I'm doing this safety first. Notice I always have my goggles on. So put this. Possible science cooking, coming right up. Here we go. Look at this. It's already frozen. As I mix up even more, check out this. Working well. All right, let's do a little bit more. We'll make do. Pour a little bit extra so you can see it actually bubbling right now. It's actually boiling as it's turning to the gas. Check that out. Now I added a lot in there, so it's a little bit frozen over, but because I've done this before, I know if you just sit a second or two, it's actually just gonna turn back into that creamy ice cream. As it's already doing it right now. And right now, we have strawberry vanilla ice cream with chocolate chips. Oh, that's great. Instant ice cream. Isn't that amazing? Ice cream in seconds. I mean, who's got time for all that freezing? Good stuff.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make ice cream instantly. And if you enjoy just bringing crazy ideas to life through science, let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends. And if you want to learn more about crazy experiments that don't sound possible, well, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. I love science.
That wasn't strong enough.
My little spoon.